Greetings. I come in the name of your United Federation of Planets.
Greetings, Lord Kirk.
Ooh.
I am Imanata.
Imanata.
I regret the discomfort that I put you through on your ship. I wish only to preserve my joy by serving the Savant.
Are you willing to help me, Imanata?
Savant? What the hell do you want, Enchilada?
Where is Spock? How did you come to be here? What were you doing on my ship? Are you willing to help? What were you doing on my ship?
Yeah, what were you doing on my ship?
The Savant empowered me to remove any psionically adept being from your ship, and to prevent you from following him. It was not our intention to do you harm.
Who's this Savant?
The Savant is now summoned, Lord Kirk. He awaits.
Lord Kirk?
Not many footsteps from here, by the fountainhead. Seek him.
Are you willing to help me, Imanata? Where is Spock?
The Lord Spock is not far. His mind dances in the bliss of this place.
Oh boy.
He would welcome you. It is not a long or difficult search to find him. The Savant awaits. I am unimportant compared to him. Go to him at once.
I will. You are the last of your race. That makes you very important.
True.
Can you talk about the Savant? Give us a chance to know what to expect.
Yes.
I will. Can you talk about the Savant?
Nothing I can say will truly prepare you for what awaits.
Are you willing to help me, Imanata?
Great.
How did you come to be here?
I was a lone soldier, fleeing the massacres that followed the Three Systems War. I was heavily outnumbered. In desperation, I attempted to use my son's gravity well to propel my ship into a high warp velocity, so I could escape the pursuit.
I remember reading about that war in my history class at the Academy.
I was warped into the Antares sector. I traveled through a dimensional rift into this place. The Savant sustained me and gave me joy where there was once only despair. I have been here ever since.
Huh. So you are wiggling around in joy. I thought you were in pain or something at first.
The Savant awaits. I am unimportant compared to him. Go to him at once.
I will. You are the last of your race. That makes you very important.
Physical forms are unimportant. A species is only a similarity of material form.
Kay.
Constructed from genetic instructions. Only emotions matter.
Are you willing to help me, Imanata?
Possibly. I am aware of your ship's distress. I can bring it to the attention of the Savant. It may help.
Actually, I was thinking more about freeing Spock.
Only emotions matter. Try telling that to Spock.
What is the Savant? I would appreciate the Savant being informed. Actually, what is the Savant?
A being found that the physical form impaired his emotions, and so he discarded it as a lord discards his raiment. An entity of great benevolence and joy. Through my psionic talents, we are linked in ecstasy eternal.
Where is the Savant?
Everywhere. When one is an entity, one transcends the limitations of space, time, and dimension. But the Savant prefers to center his thoughts at the fountainhead, which is quite close.
Interesting.
The Savant awaits.
I will. You are the last. Can you talk about the Savant? I will. Can you talk about the Savant?
Nothing I can say.
Are you willing to help me, Imanata?
Possibly.
Actually, I was thinking more about freeing Spock.
Right.
I do not know how I can help you, Captain. Speak with the Savant, and perhaps things will be clearer. The Savant awaits.
I will. You are the last. Can you talk about the Savant?
Nothing I can.
Are you willing to help me?
Possibly.
Actually, I was thinking, what is the Savant? I would appreciate the Savant being informed.
It is done. The Savant awaits.
Okay.
Save new game. Replace.
Save. I don't suppose we can walk off here, but probably that way. Well, I can't even walk anywhere near it. Alright, let's go this way. However you want to get there, Kirk, it's fine. there's danger music.
I am the Savant. I wish you and all entities nothing but joy.
Creepy.
Who are you? Why do you ensnare others against their will? Release Spock at once and allow us to return to our ship. Who are you?
Once, eons ago, I was akin to you. A creature of flesh and pain. but I released myself from these bonds and became an entity of pure emotion. And I came to this place to find a shelter from the cares of the universe.
Gotta be more than just emotion. Alright, let's look around.
The Savant.
Right.
A pouch from the Vorian life support capsule.
Oh, a pouch.
Strange boulders jut from the depths of this strange planetscape.
I'll tell you, this music's gonna get annoying really quickly. These are all the Savant?
The Savant.
There's different faces.
The Savant. The remains of a Vorian life support capsule.
Right, so all the stuff happened here, I guess.
The remains of a Vorian life support capsule. Strange boulders jut. The remains of a Vorian life. This seems pointless. Although it looks like common dirt, you've never seen anything as impenetrably. Strange boulders.
Oh, Kirk.
James Kirk, captain of the Enterprise. Pavel Chekhov, the faithful navigator of the Enterprise.
Yep, no side ship.
Angus Walker, sturdy security officer of the Enterprise.
He likes planking.
Hikaru Sulu, the trusty helmsman of the Enterprise.
Trusty, not rusty. Okay, speak amongst yourselves.
Suggestions on how to get Spock and get out of here.
Not a clue.
Sorry, Captain.
Ditto.
Ditto.
I'm afraid I'm all out of ideas. Maybe if we analyze everything, we might think of something.
That's what I often do.
Why do I have the feeling that a phaser isn't going to solve our problems this time?
Yeah, how do you, destroy emotions with a phaser?
We need to find a weakness in whatever kidnaps Spock.
Yeah, analyze stuff. Oops.
Captain, the readings are incomprehensible. The tricorder has no idea what all these waveforms represent.
I had a feeling it'd say something like that.
It's some kind of life pod, Captain. I believe it is a Vorian design. It's some kind of life pod. They seem more organic than mineral, Captain.
Save over, let's talk to this thing some more, I guess.
Captain, you misunderstand me. It is not my will to bring harm to any creature.
Okay.
I have taken two creatures that are without the most important thing in existence. Joy. And given it to them in infinite variety and abundance. The Vorian was filled with despair at the death of her race. She was overwhelmed by sorrow and grief. I have healed her of these afflictions forever. As for the Vulcan, he has been conditioned to deny his emotions. I am bringing him in contact with a part of himself that will enhance his life.
Oh boy.
It is a gift of love.
You have no right to inflict emotions on any being, regardless of how positive you may think them to be, without their consent.
True dat.
Get a life. You can't just sit around feeling happy for eternity. What does that accomplish?
Get a life, huh?
Love? Spock doesn't want your gift. He doesn't need your gift. Release him and let us return to our ship. You have no right to inflict emotions on any being, regardless of how positive you may think them to be, without their consent.
I give them an eternity of joy. Is that not every creature's desire? How can granting a subliminal desire be beyond my rights?
That is the most arrogant piece of presumption I have ever heard.
Possibly. Then again, we've spoken to Romulans before.
An eternity of joy. And I suppose you derive no benefits from the people you hold prisoner?
Good point.
Do you honestly believe that because what you do may benefit them, that the ends justify the means?
Best one.
That is the... Do you honestly believe that because what...
Yes, Captain. For such a great good as that which I provide, the ends do justify the means. I will send you back to your own ship and give you safe passage through the Antares Rift if you wish.
Not without our science officer, buddy. Let's get this thing.
The pouch appears to be composed of some sort of tanned animal hide. It's old, but not very worn.
We can put the other stones in there.
A pouch found in the wreckage of a spacecraft.
Find any more information about this pouch? Probably not.
It's just a pouch, Captain.
We talk to this thing anymore.
Welcome. Have you come to ask for transportation back to your ship?
No.
Not without Spock. Savant, isn't there anything I can do to make you see reason? Release Spock, or we will be forced to destroy you.
That wouldn't go over well.
Not without Spock. Savant, isn't there anything I can do to make you see reason?
Captain, I do see reason.
Sure you do.
My intellect is many orders of magnitude beyond yours. You should trust my judgment.
Right.
I trust Spock's judgment, and you're imprisoning his free will. Savant, creatures like ourselves need to be free to make mistakes and to learn from them. Only then can our intellects advance the many orders of magnitude that are needed to equal yours.
Very good.
Really? I see you have great power and great splendor, but I don't see great wisdom. I trust Savant, creatures like ourselves need to...
But I can elevate him to my level without any suffering. He need not experience the hardships that my race experienced. Is this not an extreme act of mercy?
Nope. It is not an extreme act of mercy. We gather some stuff.
They're a little large for the pouch, Captain. Although I agree we should take samples, we might want to find ones that are easier to carry.
Alright. We stopped this music. It's kind of annoying. I wonder if we can go that way. Thank you so much. Now, get in my pouch.
Captain, I don't think the Vurian will fit in the pouch.
Alright, let's get these.
I'll get them, Captain.
With the pouch. Don't forget the pouch, Ensign. Hope you have that pouch, Ensign.
I've put them in the pouch we found. Boy, am I getting an odd feeling from these stones.
Indeed.
A pouch. It is full of blue stones.
So maybe we could throw the stones at the Savant?
It's just a pouch, Captain.
With stones in it. Are we gonna put the stone on it? Does it make it feel sadness?
That is an odd sensation, Lord Kirk. But it is dwarfed by the bliss that the Savant gives me. That is an odd sensation.
Say that for all of them?
That is an odd
Try them all, just for the hell of it.
That is an odd sensation.
Just in case one of them works where the other doesn't.
That is an odd
What about the pouch full of stuff?
No. Grief. Pain. Gentle lords, why have you inflicted this upon me?
Aw.
I thought I was free of grief forever.
I'm sorry. We need to attract the attention of the Savant.
Huh.
I'm sorry. I wasn't sure of what would happen. I'll stop.
The joy returns. Do not take it from me again.
Okay. We'll fuse these stones on each other.
That's very strange. I just remembered the time I was shot to death in that Melkosian frontier fantasy.
Yeah.
I don't know what's in that thing, but keep it away from me.
Oh my god. Well, it's worth it just to hear all these reactions.
That's strange. I just remembered when Captain Garavik died, it was incredibly vivid.
Oh, so pain and loss, yeah.
Captain, I'm sorry. For a second, I had an image that you all had died.
Wow. So that's the blue stone. How about the red?
You Cossack! Why was I so angry?
You Cossack!
Will you leave me alone?
Captain, I'm sorry.
I think Sulu has the best performances here.
Stop that or I'll...
Stop that or I'll...
Why, you... Oh. I'm sorry, Captain. I can't believe how those stones make me feel.
To quote Spock, fascinating. The yellow.
The moment I touched the stone, I remembered an old romance.
The moment I touched the stone, I remembered an old romance.
Everybody?
I was just reminded about a summer I spent with a friend.
A friend, sure.
I would prefer if you didn't do that, Captain.
Right, he's celibate. Doesn't mean he's never been with anybody.
Captain, please. I do not need my emotions disturbed.
I don't know what these stones are doing to our emotions, but I don't like it.
G'day! Excuse me.
Life?
For a second, I was experiencing a strange sensation. I'd prefer it if you didn't do that again, sir.
Captain, may I suggest we avoid using the stones unless it's absolutely necessary?
But we're almost done. Hope I'm not losing points here. That was the orange.
Captain, please.
Yeah.
I don't know why I'm here. I've always been the junior officer, the one who's never done anything right. Why did you bring me, Captain? Why? I'm no use to Mr. Spock.
Ensign.
My apologies, Captain. I do not know what came over me.
That's all right, Ensign. It's a strange universe. It's a wonder we haven't all gone mad already.
We're the one pressing a bright stone against his chest or head or whatever the hell we're doing.
Captain, why are you doing this? Why did you bring me along in the first place? Why did I ever join Starfleet?
Ikaro, get a hold on yourself.
I don't know why I'm doing this. It's as though someone else were controlling my actions.
Captain.
What is it, Mr. Walker?
Nothing, sir.
Yeah. I hope I didn't lose points for this, but I'm just gonna save over.
Save new game. Replace pre.
Probably not gonna keep this. The bag of stuff is gonna drive everyone insane.
Captain, what are you doing?
Captain, is there a reason you're trying to fit me into a pouch?
I don't think I'll fit in this pouch.
I was trying to use the stones inside him.
I don't think that pouch is going to fit, sir. I have very big bones.
Very big bones.
They're a little large for the pouch, Captain. Although I...
Alright, let's go this way. Now what if we try to use these stones on the entity? Well, this would be interesting. I'm also wondering if we can go east.
This object has no effect against me.
Huh. I don't know if I didn't want to waste them all,
this
but...
This object has no effect against me.
We ask you if it has an effect on you? I don't think so.
This object has... This object has... This object has...
And finally...
You disturb my rest. Fortunately, I am not alone in bliss. Do not use such a tactic again on me. I warn you. What is this? What am I feeling? What have you done?
Cool.
What's the matter, Savant? Not feeling those good vibrations?
Not feeling those good vibrations.
Life isn't all happiness and joy. It's time you experienced a reality check. Is that sadness you're feeling, Savant? It couldn't be that those inferior humans have outwitted your great wisdom, could it?
Yeah, taunting.
What's the matter, Savant? Life isn't all happiness and joy.
No. I have spent millions of years trying to escape the anguish. Misery is the destroyer of worthy souls, Captain. And you are destroying me.
I'm not destroying you. Your own unwillingness to respect others is destroying you.
That's true.
Free Spock and return us to our ship and this will end.
will it? How do we get the stones out of it?
I didn't want to do this, but I have to destroy you to free my friend. I will. I'm not destroying you. Your own uncle, I'd free Spock and return us to our ship, and this will end.
No. I shall not reward this action. I will not allow violence to be rewarded, even if I must die.
I don't want to kill you, Savant.
Sheesh.
You underestimated our ability to hurt you. Maybe you underestimated us in other ways, too. You are the most stubborn entity I've ever met. If you can read Spock's mind, then you know I don't enjoy hurting others. Why can't you be reasonable? And I cannot allow you to derive pleasure from your unwarranted kidnapping of my science officer. We are in the same situation.
I like that one.
I don't want to kill you, and I cannot allow you to do.
No, Captain. I seek a greater good than freedom.
There is none.
What a foolish statement. What good is freedom if one is in grave hunger or great misery? I have freed them from pain. If you cannot appreciate this, I pity you. I cannot reward such a simplistic philosophy. Death awaits me.
Captain, without the Savant, the fabric of this universe will...
Load a previously saved game.
Wow. Okay. Can we go to another section here, or is that it? Or perhaps we just have to tell it the right questions. Oh! Spock!
Spock, what have they done to you?
Fascinating. Emotional intensity of a previously unknown level. Our link with the Savant acts as an amplifier. The more minds in union with him, the greater the level of emotion. And happiness is a powerful emotion.
Spock, do you want this?
Happiness is a human desire, Captain. I am a Vulcan. I want to be free of emotions. This is the antithesis of my desires.
Spock!
Spock? What? Why are you saying Spock? Well, that's interesting. He doesn't sound happy. He sounds just as emotionless as ever.
Mr. Spock, the best science officer in Starfleet. The wreckage of an alien derelict, the Vurian's life support pod. There are 100 archaeologists who would love to be standing with you right now.
Yeah, good. We can torture them all with emotion stones as well.
James T. Kirk, in anguish due to his friend's predicament. Lieutenant Walker, who doesn't really know any of these bridge people very well.
Bridge people.
Lieutenant Sulu, who has always had a great deal of respect for Spock's scientific talents. Ensign Chekov, who never expected to be traveling to another universe.
Kind of really like traveling around with Spock and Chekov. This is pretty awesome.
You've never seen anything as impenetrably dark as this void. Although it looks like these large, bright rocks seem to have been thrown to the surface of this planetscape from below.
From below.
Their color makes an interesting contrast with the dull color of the surrounding land.
Okay.
We must find a way to free Spock.
Captain,
there have been incidents.
What was he saying?
Where Vulcans, who were deliberately exposed to emotions, went insane. Fortunately, I do not appear to be in immediate danger.
Danger? What did he say?
Captain,
there have been...
Vulcans? What?
Captain,
there have been...
Vulcans don't like emotions?
Captain,
there have
been... Okay.
Why is this being done to Spock, Captain? What benefit does someone get from subjecting him to an emotion?
We've seen energy forms that feed on hatred.
It's
Why
feeding on
be
emotions.
Some creatures that feed on happiness? An addict who must have happiness, and who relies on others to fulfill an increasing need for more happiness.
Yeah. That's what I'm thinking.
Captain, wouldn't stunning Mr. Spock break whatever control that he's under?
Unless we deal with the creature that's doing this, it would only provide temporary relief.
Right, if he was unconscious, that kind of thing.
The pod was constructed from a high-grade Jupiterium steel alloy, Captain. No signs of life, no signs of power. My guess was that it was irreparably damaged on entry into this dimension. The Vurian is lucky to be alive.
Hmm. Jupiterium.
They seem more... Now this is strange.
But it feels like minerals to me.
Tricorders don't...
It could be a deception, Captain.
Yeah, same thing he did before.
Captain, it's a complete void.
A nothingness between universes, perhaps.
Perhaps. How's Spock look?
Captain, the tricorder registers him as Spock.
Okay. Medically, how is Spock doing?
Captain, Mr. Spock is normal, except for accelerated brain activity in the areas of his brain that control psionic abilities. He is currently in a mind meld.
Oh, he's in a mind meld. Usually it's the other way around. Putting other people in mind meld. So I'm gonna save now.
Save new game. Replace.
And I gotta talk to him and mess with stones on him.